he's a good fighter, a great fighter, definitely a great fighter. But it made me have a little bit more confidence. No matter if he was in a gym for a day or in a gym for 6 weeks, I still know what's inside of him, and I still know that I could compete with him for every bit of 12 rounds.
So you handled him?
I did well against him, yes, I did.
I mean, the first two rounds were, you take one or I'll take the other. But after that, Paul just handled him like he owned him. His nose is bleeding, and that eye looks like it's swelling up, and he kept cracking him. Finally, the fourth round, Mayweather comes to me and asks me if he could get out of the ring because he says he's tired. I says, you ain't getting out of the ring. You're getting your ass kicked today to teach you for all the big mouth you had in your father. So after it was all over, he's laying on the ground for 20 minutes, completely exhausted, and I'm taping it. And I sent this tape to Lou Tabella, and Lou Tabella was in shock. Next thing I know, we're not getting the fight. So vicious animal that's supposed to be greatest boxer of all time, and I'll tell you right now, if they ever make that match, Paul Spadafore will be right in his chest, and he'll get his heart rate up to over 270 beats and might run him out of the damn ring. Here's a guy that's not even a puncher who kicked his ass once, and I think he'll kick it again.
I'm gonna shit to you. Why are you calling me?
Why don't you train it, Susie?
Yeah.
You don't like training?
What do you mean? I just got done training.
No.
Hang out what? Have you met Jerry?
How are you doing? Nice to meet you.
He's the one that got me ready for
the conference. Oh, really?
He's trying to kill me, Jerry.
Yeah, Paul.
I just want